So, good evening. This is a tutorial on algebraic division. It's a skill that is valuable across many areas of mathematical courses. So, watch this very carefully. You can see I've put or not if possible. I'm also going to show you a way around it in some situations. But make sure you learn this skill. This tutorial was requested on my Twitter account, and you can request anything you need there as well. So look out for that and the Facebook link at the end of this page. So here I've been given a polynomial, which is a cubic, and I've been told that x plus 3 is a factor. I've been told to factorise f of x completely. And one way to do this is to divide my polynomial by the factor to give myself a simpler equation to work with. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to show you how to do it. So we set up the polynomial 2x cubed plus 3x squared minus 29x. Notice we're doing it in descending powers of x all the way down from my top power. And I'm going to divide this whole thing by x plus 3. So the first thing I ask myself is, what do I need to times x by to make 2x cubed? What do I need to times x by to make 2x cubed? It would be 2x squared. Now I multiply 2x squared by x, which gives me obviously 2x cubed, that's the whole point. And I also multiply 2x squared by 3, and that would give me plus 6x squared. I now subtract, so you can see here I have 2x cubed, take away 2x cubed is 0, it always will be, and 3x squared take away 6x squared, and that gives me minus 3x squared. So, what do I need to times x by here to make 3x squared? Well, minus 3x squared. And that would be minus 3x. Minus 3x times x is minus 3x squared. Now, minus 3x times 3 is minus 9x. I now do the simple subtraction again. So, minus 3x squared minus minus 3x squared is 0. It always will be. But I also have minus 29x minus minus 9x. That's minus 29x plus 9x, which equals minus 20x. What do I need to times x by to make minus 20x? Well, that's minus 20, because minus 20 times x is minus 20x. And minus 20 times 3 is minus 60. I now perform subtraction. Minus 20x minus minus 20x is 0. It always will be. Minus 60 minus minus 60, that's minus 60 plus 60, is 0. So there is no remainder. Indeed, x plus 3 is a factor of f of x. And to make this polynomial, I could take x plus 3 and times it by 2x squared minus 3x minus 20. And that is algebraic division. I'm now going to carry on this question and factorise f of x completely. And I'm also going to show you a shortcut if you're not particularly good at algebraic division. But that's how we do it. Be careful. Descending powers of x. If we didn't have an x squared term, we'd leave a blank there, or write plus 0, so that everything still lines up with the relevant powers of x. All that's really required for me to finish this off is to factorise the quadratic. When you're asked to factorise completely, you should indeed factorise completely, and many people forget to do that. Now, you should be able to see this is x plus 3, and then I just need to factorise this. So I'll have 2x and x, and then I just need to work out what numbers go where. And indeed, you should see that this is minus 2x. 4, which would give me minus 8x, and then plus 5 to take me back to minus 3x. And that's the answer to that question. If you need help with factorisation of quadratics, then do watch other tutorials. Do request any to be made if you need any particular help. But I'm now going to show you a shortcut in this particular question where you wouldn't need to use algebraic division. So, here's my original question. I have a cubic, 2x cubed plus 3x squared. I'm just going to write this out. 2x cubed plus 3x squared minus 29x minus 60. And I'm told that x plus 3 is a factor. So, I'm going to have x plus 3. And then I've got to work out the quadratic that it's going to be. Now, the first step is relatively easy. I know I need to make 2x cubed. So I clearly need 2x squared, because x times 2x squared would give me 2x cubed. Another easy term to calculate is the minus 60 at the end. I have plus 3, so I obviously need minus 20 to give me minus 60. Now I just consider the x squared term here, the 3x squared. You see, at the moment, the x squared terms I would have there would give me plus 6x squared. But I don't want to add 6x squared, I just want to add 3x squared. So I consider the x term and what I need to times it by, bearing in mind I now need to make minus 3x squared. And that's because 6x squared minus 3x squared is the plus 3x squared I require. And you can see, very simply, to make minus 3x squared, this would need to be minus 3x. And I've actually got the quadratic that I managed to get through the algebraic division using the more formal and proper approach. To finish the question, I would then simply factorise the quadratic that I've generated. And just as before, the 2x and the x would give me the 2x squared minus 4 plus 5. So you can see that method is a lot quicker. But algebraic division is a skill and a necessary one that you do need, so make sure you learn it. But also learn this shortcut if you understand it, because you'll get valuable time in your examination. Follow me on Twitter at MathAllMaths and check out my Facebook page. You can get regular updates of exam questions and technique tutorials, but more importantly, request tutorials such as this on any technique you need. Good luck with all of your examinations. I am here if you need any help at all.